In this GIMP workshop, we will make a multi-layer stencil in color with three layers. If you want to follow along, you can find the download link for the image in the video description. Go to File, Open, and search for the image you want to use, and open it. Right-click on the layer and hit Add Alpha Channel. When we use a color photo, we first go to Colors and Desaturate. We can leave the default settings as they are and just click OK. We will start by removing the background. Go to the toolbox and activate the selection tool of your choice. I've chosen for the Path tool. Zoom in by holding the Ctrl key and rolling the mouse wheel. We will start by the hair, and here we can improvise a bit because the edges are a bit blurry and vague. Click the first node. Then click the second node. Hold the left mouse button down and drag the handle out to make a curve. Then let go of the mouse. Move the handle by click and drag back to its node and let go of the mouse again. Then click the next node. Keep the left mouse button down and drag out the handle to make the curve. Let go of the mouse. Place by click and drag the handle back to its node. And that is how the Path tool works, so we can continue in this way. With Ctrl Z we can undo one or more previous steps. When we press and hold the mouse wheel, we can, by moving the mouse, move the whole image. This can of course also be done with the scroll bars in case you do not work with a mouse. For the sake of the tutorial, we will now go fast forward. Back at the first point, we can place the cursor over the first point and press the Ctrl key. When we see the chain icon, we can click and our path is closed. Go to View, Zoom, and then Fit Image in Window to maximize the image. Click on the button Selection from Path or hit Enter to make our selection. Click on a random tool in the toolbox to make the path invisible. Go to Select and click Invert so the background and not the girl is selected. Now we go to Edit and hit Clear so the background is removed. Click on Select and hit None. Now we click two times on the Duplicate button at the bottom of the Layers panel to make two duplicates. We have three layers now. You can of course make as many layers as you like. Click on the New Layer button, name it Background, make the layer fill type white, and click OK. Press and hold the Shift key and hit the green downwards pointing arrow so this layer goes to the bottom of the layer stack. Then we press and hold the Shift key again, and now we click on the eye of the top layer to make the other layers invisible. Make the top layer active. Then we go to Colors and Threshold. Here we reduce the black by sliding the arrowhead to the left. Keep in mind that the black that remains will be the darkest color in our image. Usually it looks best to keep some black, especially at the eyes, nose and mouth. Click OK. Click on the Select by Color tool and then in the white of the image. Now go to Edit and hit Clear to remove all the white. Then click in the black of the image to select it. Click on the foreground button of the foreground background colors to open the color palette. Here we can choose our darkest color. You can of course choose any color you like, but usually it works best when we use darker colors for the darker areas and lighter colors for the lighter areas. I've chosen for a dark green. Fill in the HTML notation 1, 1, 3, 5, 0, 0. Hit enter. Now we can drag and drop this color from the current old preview pane into the image. Go to select and hit none. Make this layer invisible by clicking on the eye and make the second layer from above visible and active. Go to colors again and threshold. The color palette disappears momentarily. Now we move the arrowhead in a way that we keep a bit more black than we did by the top layer. Click OK. And there is the color palette again. Activate the Select by Color tool and click again in the white of the image. Go to Edit and hit Clear to remove it. Now click in the black to select it. Double click on the HTML notation and fill in A 2 1 1 1 and 1. Hit enter. Drag and drop this color into the image. We can make the top layer as well as the white background layer visible to see how we're doing. Go to select and hit none. Then press and hold the shift key and click on the eye of the third layer from above to make this one visible and the other three invisible. Make this layer also active. Go to colors, threshold again, and slide the arrowhead in a way that you get a lot of black, like so. Click OK. Click once more on the Select by Color tool, and then in the black of the image to select it. Double click on the HTML notation and fill in E 5 9 F 3 B. Hit enter. Drag and drop this color into the image. Click in the white. Double click again on the HTML notation and fill in F B F F C E. Hit enter and bring this color into the image by drag and drop. Go to select and hit none again. Press and hold the shift key and hit the eye of the third layer to make all the layers visible. Make the background layer active. Double click for the last time on the HTML notation and fill in 2, 7, 5, 7, 8, 8. Hit enter and drag and drop this color into the image. Now we can close the color palette. And there we have it, a multi-layer stencil in color. Besides choosing your own colors, it might be a nice idea to use one color with different levels of brightness, like this example image. Anyway, I hope you have fun with this workshop, and if that's the case, please be so kind to give it a like, maybe post a nice comment, and subscribe if you haven't done already to support my channel. I would appreciate it very much. Thank you for watching.